I'll admit that it is an unadulterated sales brochure for what might be a military machine. I have an association, a license agreement at the moment, with a British company which is in the aerial reconnaissance specialisation. And I've done a lot of work for them carrying their special equipment and so on. And eventually they said, look, we should make the aircraft as well. And so this little brochure film is made by them. But it's quite a useful little film because it shows some of the work that they've been doing, like landing on moving lorries and putting down the very first.
Its principle and design are fundamentally different. It is also lighter, smaller, and relatively inexpensive to purchase and maintain, yet possesses many other unique capabilities. This autogyro, based on the designs and research of Wing Commander Ken Wallace, is now being produced by W. Vinton Limited at their factory in Bury St. Edmunds, Southwark, England. An autogyro has a conventional propeller to provide forward propulsion. The actual lift is provided by this two-bladed, freely rotating wing or rotor. One problem created by a rotating wing is that as the aircraft moves forward, the advancing blade generates more lift than the retreating blade, thus getting unequal lift. This has been overcome by the rotor head design, which permits the rotor blades to pivot up and down, as well as rotating around the central axis. The principle can be demonstrated by this model. Here, the two blades are allowed to pivot on the central rotating bearing. When tilted at an appropriate angle, a gentle breeze rotates the blades. If they then advance into the wind, they will speed up and generate more lift. An autogyro's rotor is freely rotating, but to shorten the takeoff run, it's coupled to the engine to spin it up to speed. The rotor head contains a gearbox, and this is linked by means of a flexible shaft down to a simple clutch mechanism at the rear of the engine. In operation, lifting this lever first engages the gearbox and then lowers the clutch wheel onto the engine shaft. The engine is then advanced to give a rotor speed of about 300 revs per minute. As the throttle is further increased for takeoff, it automatically disengages the gearbox and clutch. Rotor speed now being maintained by passage through the air. The control column performs in the same manner as a conventional aircraft. The engine is a two-cylinder, flat twin, four-stroke. Various types and designs have been used previously, but a Westlake 80 horsepower model will be used in the production.